Welcome back to Savage Kitchen. It's Tuesday and we're tasting things. Today we're going to be tasting tequila. I'm excited about this because I haven't been a big tequila drinker. I, like many people in their early 20s, made the mistake of having way too much of terrible tequila one night, regretting it, and then swearing off it for pretty much a decade. And then another decade went by and here we are. So I lately have found that there are some tequilas I enjoy. Typically, they tend to be reposados. And reposados are tequilas that have been aged, usually in oak barrels. And as a result, they seem to pick up the qualities of a lot of brown liquors, like a bourbon or a rye. That's my wheelhouse. I enjoy bourbon quite a lot. So getting into reposados has been sort of a nice little toe in the water with tequila, and I'm excited to explore a little bit more. So we're going to be trying this reposado and this Blanco, both from the same brand. This is from Teremana, and Teremana is Dwayne The Rock Johnson's tequila company, because why wouldn't The Rock have tequila? I mean, really. I'm excited about this brand. Similar to the blackened whiskey, this isn't a liquor company that just has like a celebrity endorsement or somebody sticking their name on it. From what I understand, Dwayne The Rock Johnson is heavily involved in the process of distilling this tequila and is very passionate about the results. And I think that's super cool. There's obviously a lot of care and attention to detail that goes into the production of these bottles. So we're gonna start with the Blanco, and these are fresh bottles. I've been pretty much living at Total Wine lately. Oh, it's a good sound. That's really good. Now the Blanco, oh God, that smells good. So the Blanco, the difference between the Blanco and the Reposado is that they both come from the same agave plant. It's the same part of the agave, and both of them go through a roasting process where they roast the agave in brick ovens before it is distilled in copper pots. The difference between the two is after that distillation process, the Blanco is bottled. The Reposado, after the distillation process, goes to oak barrels and sits. So the Blanco theoretically will be a little bit lighter and brighter. God, it just smells really good. Let's just give a taste. And I'm tasting these pretty much at room temperature. They're a little bit cool just because it's cold out. Oh my God, I can't get over how good that smells. For somebody who doesn't like tequila, I really like how this smells. Okay. Wow. I'm very pleasantly surprised. This is much sweeter than I anticipated it being, but maybe that's because I have PTSD from bad tequila. I mean, when you've been in Mexico and had it put in your mouth via water gun, you know, makes you cringe a little. This is really good. Wow, that's delicious. It's very, you could definitely drink this on its own. This is going to be fantastic. I have a couple of margarita recipes that I'm working on. That's going to be really good. It's definitely far sweeter than I anticipated. It definitely does not have the punch you in the face quality that a lot of the Jose Cuervos of the world seem to possess. Sorry if that offends anyone, but not really. Wow, okay, that's delicious. I don't know that my tequila palate is sophisticated enough to identify, you know, types of agave or regional differences in how tequilas are made, because I know that there are some. This is a Highlands tequila, and I know that small batch tequila production is a very, you know, intricate world with all kinds of different processes, but this is just delicious. This is very good. All right, let's try the Reposado. Let me get the lid back on. favorite sound. Mmm. See, right away with this one, I can smell, this also smells good, but I can smell oak, I can smell vanilla, all of those things that I like in brown spirits, I can smell them in this. I'm excited. All right, let's give this a try. Wow. Ooh, it does, it definitely does. It smells different. They're both, it smells sweet like the Blanco does, but it has a different quality to it that must come from the oak barrel aging because it's a little bit warmer. Ooh, okay, yeah. Wow, they're very different. Ooh, I like that a lot. This has a smokiness to it that's very subtle. Not at all like the smokiness that you would find in a mezcal. You can definitely smell the oak. You can smell vanilla. You can smell joy. Mm-hmm. Oh, that's just damn good. Okay, drinking these on their own, not in a cocktail, my personal preference, unsurprisingly, is the Reposado. However, I'm very, very pleasantly surprised by the Blanco and how good that is. I'm excited to try that in a couple of cocktails. This, the Reposado, also I think is gonna be great in, I have a couple ideas for some smoky cocktails that I think this will be delicious in. But it's very good, especially for the price point. These were each right around $30 a bottle, $32 maybe, which I think for a not top shelf, but also not bottom of the barrel, like a middle of the road spirit, I think is a really good price. And I love, so the brand, Teremana, Teri meaning earth, Mana meaning spirit. Dwayne Johnson goes on to talk about how mana is a Polynesian word for spirit. And he also goes on to talk about how this is the people's tequila, the people's spirit, which I think is A, brilliant marketing, but B, lovely and heartfelt. And it's just so nice. And at the price that it's at and how available it is, it really kind of is the people's tequila. So well done. I'm just gonna sit here and enjoy the hell out of the rest of this. But I got some margarita ideas. So Teremana, I like it. Big fan. Thanks for joining me on Tasting Tuesday. Cheers, friends.